is Corinne Mink, I believe.
Corinne Mink. This is very interesting because
these two young ladies wrestled at the
previous Eclipse show.
Yes, last November.
And believe it or not, Gemma put her LaFemme title, Phoenix LaFemme title, on the line against Corinne Mink.
What?
So here we go, Corinne Mink getting ready for this matchup. A submission match.
This should keep Blue awake.
Yeah.
I doubt that. I think it's past his bedtime.
Blue!
Oh.
I swear. And here comes the reigning Phoenix Pro LaFemme champion, Gemma Cross.
Along with her manager.
With AC Norway.
AC Norway manages Gemma Cross here in Eclipse Wrestling.
And if this is a rematch from the last Eclipse show back on Veterans Day.
Sure
where Gemma retained.
And there's Gemma looking very sparkly.
I asked Corinne Mink out on a date. She told me to sit down.
I don't know what that means.
That's probably the nicest thing she would have said to you.
I said, hey, you're pretty. You want to go get some wings?
Didn't
work.
She didn't thank you for being a friend, that's for sure.
It probably would have worked for me.
Thank you, sir.
Your food is delivered, actually.
Yes.
What is that?
This is the X-Man Protein Special. Cheese and meat. Try it. It's good.
I am.
Are you allowed to eat that? I don't know if it's kosher.
I don't care.
Oh, well, it's Easter. It's good, isn't it?
It is good as I crunch into the microphone. I apologize.
That's all right.
Sorry, Bill. That's almost like a taco salad.
It is taco meat. Without the chips.
Without the chips.
Well, X is meal brought to you by orderyourway.com.
Are you serious?
Proud sponsor here in Eclipse Wrestling as well as Phoenix Pro Wrestling.
Says keep me on your fridge.
Order it your way. You can go to the website. They will bring you anything. They will bring you places that don't normally deliver, including McDonald's, KFC, Cobras, and other local restaurants. Order
KFC?
Your way. Yes, orderyourway.com. The only way to order food is you don't feel like driving for. So anyway, this matchup
is a rematch.
The LaFemme title on the line. Again, this is a Phoenix Pro Wrestling title. Interesting it's being defended here, but AC Norway is her manager at the ringside, so this is sanctioned by Phoenix Pro Wrestling.
Well, we know that for sure.
Yeah,
because AC is here.
That is confirmed that it is.
The other match is still in question, but they retained, so it's sort of a moot point.
Look at Gemma. Gemma, and with that cross arm breaker on Corinne Mink, the Golden Girl Corinne Mink.
Thank you for being.
She likes to say that she's a little bit of Rhodes and a little bit of Blanche.
She looks more like Sophia to me.
And a whole lot of Sophia. I don't blame her. Nobody wants to be B. Arthur.
Well, B. Arthur wasn't the most attractive one.
Well, B. Arthur didn't want to be B. Arthur.
No.
She's a very handsome man.
And then there's Maude.
Anyway, we've got to lock up again. Gemma going right to work on that arm. Sorry, but it's a submission match. She's doing a great job as far as attacking that left arm. Now she's not ready to rip it out of the socket. Knee in the middle of the back. Pull it backwards. Your shoulder and arm is not meant to bend that way.
No, it's not.
Corinne down in the middle of the ring. Very easily could be a tap out. Nowhere broke, but Corinne. The bigger of the two, probably the more powerful of the two. Says Gemma to the ropes. Gemma to the second. Back kick. Version of a mule kick right there. Although I would never call Gemma a mule, that's for sure.
I ain't no mule.
Yeah, your ears are too short. And look at this. Gemma in a go behind. Now
wow.
Has her in a sleeper hold.
That was pretty impressive.
Legs grapevine. But unfortunately, too close to the ropes. Corinne Mink reaching for the ropes. Arm drag by Gemma Cross. Again, another arm drag. Again, working over that left arm. Gemma came in here with a game plan. I wonder how much of this was actually AC kind of coaching her and getting her ready for this matchup.
Well, I'll tell you what, AC Norway has been around this business a long time.
Yes.
And he's a man of few words. You gentlemen both know him.
I know him quite well.
No,
but let me tell you, there's a lot of knowledge in that little bald head over there.
Well, very smart. Not just the fact, but look at this. Very, going for a head scissors, and now the backbreaker by Corinne Mink. Obviously, again, the bigger, stronger of the two. Well, AC Norway, his father was Alex O. Norway, owned the wrestling promotion around here. So all that knowledge was passed on to AC.
The late Alex O. Norway.
And now Corinne is choking out Gemma. This is not a way to get a submission. It's a submission matchup. This is not, you can't tap out that way. Against Wolf Jack, doing the best he can, backing her up, getting out of that chokehold.
Chokehold, and it's a submission only match.
Corinne just putting the stomps to Gemma Cross. As our gentlemen, as my gentlemen to my right, are both eating their food from orderedyourway.com. Oh, nice knee lift into the midsection by Corinne Mink.
I did have mine delivered.
Corinne Mink now going for
mine was delivered too.
Corinne Mink, oh, look at that. Corinne, I don't know what she was going for, but she's getting caught into a variation of the triangle choke.
There you go.
Very smart. Got the arm, got the legs wrapped around, got the arm where it should be. I mean, she got that leg in tight. Corinne, I don't know if she can get out of this.
I don't know. It looks pretty precarious.
Now, oh, wait a minute. There's the power of Corinne Mink we were mentioning. All right.
Oh, that did not end well.
And maybe a little bit of B. Arthur right there.
I think that might have broke Gemma's back.
But look at this. Corinne Mink, wisely, going for a half of Boston Crab, turning into a submission hold, telling him she held on. And now, Gemma trying to make it to the bottom rope. Keep an eye on AC. Make sure he doesn't move the ropes to her. Okay. AC, clean. I'll give him credit for that. I've known AC a long time. I know there's been times when he will skew the rules a little bit, shall we say. Corinne just... Man, right hands. Jeez. Laying them in on Gemma Cross. Pillar to post. Corinne in the corner. Running clothesline. And again... Putting the boots to her in the corner. What they would call back in the day is a mud hole stomping.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Corinne, give her some space. I'm not sure I would do this. If you got your opponent down like she has Gemma, I would be staying on her. I don't know if I would have given her that little bit of time.
She gave her a little bit too much time, I think, Edwards. Yeah, although she's down, she's not out.
No, that's exactly it. She gave her a little recovery. Here we go. Sending her to ropes. Again, not sure this is wise. Just as I say that, Corinne, that sit-out powerbomb, Jack should not be going for cover. This is a submission match. Oh, my.
Look at that.
That strength into the Boston Crab. All she has to do is sit down. There she is. Now she's fully seated. She's got the legs wrenched. She's got that locked in tight.
And Gemma is nowhere near the ropes.
Right in the middle of the ring.
And she's right in the center.
Gemma trying to pull her way, but Corinne just powering her back. Doesn't have it locked in very well now. Gemma able to reverse it, double boots, kicks her off. Gemma Cross, Kurtman back to vertical base. Now Gemma showing a little bit of aggression, lining those forearms in, those chops, chopping down the bigger tree in this matchup. Off the ropes, look for a wheelbarrow, bulldog! It's again, when it comes down to this title, when it comes down to being the LaFemme title, this is prestige, this is honor. This title is actually being defended in two different promotions currently. So when you're the champion, you want the prestige, you want the honor of being that champion. Right now,
you are correct.
Gemma up to the vertical base, Corinne working her way back up to her feet. I don't know why Gemma didn't stay on her. Now she's going for the head scissors again. And again, I don't know how to take down. Now going back to that arm bar. Look at the way she's sitting in the back. She's got the arm grapevine through her arm, right out of her hand in the shoulder, wrenching back on it. Corinne Mink able to roll over, alleviate some of that pressure, back up to a vertical base, both girls, off the ropes, and going for that flying head scissors. You gonna try for it?
Oh, look at it.
The Royal Octopus hold. Doesn't have him locked in there. She's got the leg grapevine. She's finally got the leg grapevine.
That's it.
That's it.
So that's the second time.
Yeah, I don't think Corinne Mink's gonna get a rematch anytime.
I don't think she should.
Corinne goes to the back of the line as far as the LaFemme title is concerned. Better luck next time, Corinne.
Lee Arthur would not be happy.
And she would not. The Golden Girl herself heading back to sunny Miami, Florida. Although I am a little bit jealous of that, she can place her weather and we get the crap we have around here. Thank you for being a contender.
Well, there you go.
Gemma Cross, you're LaFemme champion. Been a very proud champion so far. And with under the tutelage of AC Norway, has been very, very successful.
Don't worry about that.